Alright, what is going on, guys? I'm back here with another, just with the roster, and it's kind of crazy how good it is, so just showing the goalies not to reveal anything. Then we're going to go into my actual, like, what I'd probably play as roster, just taking into consideration chemistry and stuff like that. So when I get change team cards, most of these signs will be 100%. I can easily switch Richards over there, but first line's fairly solid. You got Zetterberg, Kadri, and Marleau. All pretty good skates. All good shots. All good hands. You know, defense really isn't an issue with them. So, fairly solid line there. And then, not to be outdone, we've got a fairly good second line here, which is a bit of an interesting combination because normally I try to keep the skate the same. Which I could have opted for Taze, but I'll go into depth why I didn't. And I just like Daniel Sedin and Corey Perry both have really great shots in this game. Ribeiro has a good one too, but look at his hands. He's got 95 hands, which means he's going to be able to distribute the puck to those guys fairly easily. He's going to be able to beat people to pucks fairly easily. While he may not be the strongest defensively, he's got very, very strong offensive categories, and I think that'll really help this line out overall. And then into the third line, we got the Stanley Cup line right here. All these players have won the Stanley Cup, and that's kind of interesting having a line like that, especially since they're all Stanley Cup additions. But we got Mike Richards, who I could easily use a change team card on and change him over. This is with careful consideration, once again, of chemistry here. But we got Mike Richards, Jonathan Taze, and Dustin Brown. So skating's not a huge difference here, but it is still, I mean, it's not as big as this line, but I think the best fit for Ribeiro was the second line because he just doesn't fit in on that first line. I could switch him with Kadri, but ultimately I just think it's probably better off on that second line, and I think Kadri's a bit better off on the first line personally. Then we got the fourth line, which is, you know, only Parise, Gretzky, and Nash. You know, once again, similar skates, similar shots, hands are all even. Checking on Nash is insane. And then we go to the defense here, and my defense is fairly solid. I just added Finofin pretty much, and he's on the last pairing simply because he's with Larson, and I don't have a strong right D2A D yet. Well, I did. I just traded him away. So, like, Petrangelo could go there. But overall, this is a very, very satisfactory D line here. So, everything kind of looks very good there. And then I made one more here called Boomtown, which is pretty much throwing out all the best overall players I can get onto the team. And so, our centers look a bit... Hang on. We gotta change the second and third lines up here. Gretzky, you're in there. You're in there. And then you're in there. All right. Bring the chemistry down a little bit here. So on this first line here, we've got Team of the Year Zetterberg. First line stays the same. So I'm just getting fairly happy with that line. So that's going to stay the same. Second line changes up a little bit, and we throw Nash and Parise on your Taze side. Once again, similar skates, similar shots, similar hands, similar pretty much everything except for checking. Once again, checking is Nash's strong point and defense is Taze's, and then Parise is kind of a bit more offensive minded but a little bit lower overall too, so got to keep that in mind. Third line, just the get it to Daniel line. So these two guys right here, you know, although they've got great shots themselves, which are almost, well, Gretzky's is better than Daniel's, they got great hands and can distribute that puck fairly easily to Daniel there. He's going to just snipe all day for them. And also, if we get into 4-on-4 here, we got two centers here, so we'll always have a center out. And then this one's kind of just, you're going to get wrecked. And I was going to throw Rick Nash on this line, but I think it's better off with Perry and Getzlaff and Brown here. And this line, the Pacific Coast wrecking ball, I guess. Yeah. Similar skates, similar shots, similar hands, similar checking, similar D's. It's going to be a line that does a lot of damage. Then we go into the D pairings here, and we got Phaneuf and Carlson. So, fairly good top pairing there. Second pairing, we got two Canucks. We got Edler and Ham Hughes there. And then third pairing, we've got Johnson and Campbell. So once again, fairly solid. And once again, same goalies in. So salary on that team is $3,348. On the bench, we have Palmville, Sedin, Sharp, Kopitar, OEL, and Richards. And then on the bench for the Dream Team, yeah, it's kind of stacked. We got Palmville, Getzlaff, Kopitar. Kopitar, again, didn't make the cut on both teams. Sharp actually doesn't make the cut on this team. Normally he would have, but I like this combination a bit better here, so that's kind of what I went with. I could throw Richardson up here and move Ribeiro down and put him on the second line there instead of Daniel, but I just feel this one's better chemistry-wise, so that's kind of what I went with. So a lot of people were asking about it, and these are my line setup. So I'll probably do another trade video tomorrow. It's kind of late here, so I'm definitely just going to check the market one last time and then go to bed and rest up for tomorrow. Anyways, guys, hopefully you enjoyed the two-part video here for the trade day. Bit of a busier one and lots of great trades. So in kind of recap of the trade day, we got in for the team of the year, Zetterberg. We got team of the week, Zetterberg, and Jonathan Toews, which I wasn't expecting to move him this time, but that was a fairly good deal. Then for the team of the week, we got Ribeiro, 30K, the regular Zetterberg, Rick Nash, and then for the Kunitz, which was I think the only other trade we made, we got the Perry, another Patrick Marleau. We got, who else was in there? Getzlaff and Phaneuf. That's pretty much all our trades. That's actually very, very solid in my opinion. And, you know, having the pucks left over is kind of key. So I'm probably going to go ahead and list these guys for an hour and see if they sell at all. But anyways, guys, as always, take it easy. Thank you for watching. Hopefully you enjoyed the kind of overview of my hut team. I know you guys wanted to see one. And yeah, peace out.